Christian Fleetwood became an icon for a lot of African Americans and for a lot of white folks in the United States because he achieved so much.
Glenn T. Johnston, Chair of Humanities and Public History at Stevenson University, says from the beginning, Christian Fleetwood's life was exceptional.
He was born a free black man in 1820 in Baltimore, and his dad happened to work for a sugar merchant, a really special sugar merchant, who said, gee, Christian, why don't I school you along with my own children?
Educated and ambitious, he went overseas to work in South Africa, then came back to the U.S. to attend college, graduated valedictorian. Then he and some colleagues created the first African-American literary magazine south of the Mason-Dixon Line. And when the Civil War broke out, he became one of tens of thousands of black men to join the Army.
He was placed in the U.S. Colored Troops, the USCT, as they called it at that time. And within 3 days, he was promoted to the highest rank the Army had for people who enlisted. It's called Regimental Sergeant Major.
His bravery and leadership shine bright at the Battle of Chaffin's Farm in Virginia.
All of their color bearers are getting shot left and right. The troops don't know where the commanders are. And at a key time in the battle, Christian Fleetwood reaches down, picks up the American colors, and in effect says, follow me, boys.
Thus making himself a target. Fleetwood survived and won the Medal of Honor, yet was denied a promotion. He left the Army and joined the D.C. National Guard, eventually achieving his dream of becoming an officer. Fleetwood achieved a lot, as did other African-American soldiers, yet they remain relatively unknown.
I believe we have decades, if not over a century, of historians who chose not to pay much attention to it.
Johnston is attempting to change that. He and some dedicated students spent several years of their free time creating these display panels. These are just four of 38 panels depicting African-American war heroes spanning the year 1634 to today.
It is the largest exhibit of its kind in U.S. history, and the panels will be touring libraries in Maryland coming up this spring. Mindy Becerra, WBAL-TV 11 News.